In the last class, we have learned about the availability of food grains in the table. Now we are going to learn about the food grains mainly divided into two categories. Cereals, edible oil, pulses. These cereals are again divided into coarse cereals and fine cereals. Coarse cereals include jowar, bajra, ragi. And fine cereals include rice as well as a wheat. We think coarse cereals are rough and unhealthy, but according to nutritionists and scientists, in the coarse cereals only we are having more nutrients and that are very good for health. And many people's staple diet is also coarse cereals, such as ragi, jowar, bajra and other millets. And fine cereals include rice and wheat. They are compared as a fine cereals because the British people used to prefer the color which are white in color. That's why they are called as a fine cereals. But when we are comparing to fine cereals and wheat cereals, in the coarse cereals only we are having the more potential needs. And now there is a crop diversification in order to increase income. Farmers are showing interest in the crop diversification. If necessary water facility and irrigation facilities will be available, then only we can able to go for the crop diversification. Otherwise, there will be a loss to the farmers. For example, in Telangana region, some farmers, instead of growing or cultivating food crops, they used to prefer and cultivated cash crop such as cotton. That lead to so much of destruction and that may even lead to suicides in the Telangana. That's why when proper planning and proper water facilities are available, then only crop diversification will be need and useful. Now the people are demanding more fruits, vegetables, milk, meat, poultry, fishes. It is very good for the health and it is a good sign for the consumers as well as a producers. To increase the income, instead of paying attention for the cash crops, it is better to give importance for cultivation of vegetables. And at the same time, if farmers pay attention to allied activities such as poultry, fishing and dairying, they can able to attain more income. And nutrition suggests that every person in India should eat 300 grams of vegetables. That is the suggestion or advice of the nutrition. But 100 grams of fruits per in a day, that must be taken average. But whereas the availability of vegetables per person is 180, according to the nutrition, he told that 300 grams of vegetables are needed, but only 180 grams of vegetables are available per person. In the same manner, 100 grams of fruits are necessary and needed per person per day, whereas availability is only 58 grams of fruits. In the same manner, similarly, the person requires 180x per 180x, but whereas availability is 30 only. In the same manner, meat requirement is also per year nearly 11 kilograms of meat is necessary, but whereas availability is only 3.2 kilograms per person per year. In the same manner, Milk also is essential and potential for people, which is needed 300 millimeters of milk per person per day, whereas availability is only 210 millimeters a day, so that the calories will be less if we take less amount of food or less amount of fruits or less quantity of milk or less quantity of meat. Mainly due to the poverty and due to the less income, the people are able to consume less quantity, and farmers are needed the support of government, and then only if market opportunities will be good. And they, if that government support will not be there, means the farmers have to face the problems and market risk also. In the same manner, agriculture diversification, according to the need, it must be done. Unnecessarily, if agriculture diversification will be made, means there will be a loss. Then for the government also, there will be a policy dilemma whether to give importance to the cultivation of food grains or whether to give importance to the cultivation of non-food grains. Food grains cultivation will give less income. Even though it will give less income, it is only consumed by the people more when compared to non-food grains. In, for example, in village Midnapore area, the farmers are growing two crops because of having sufficient amount of water, and nobody is not having more than 2 acres. Even though because of having water facilities, they are able to cultivate the food grains, at the same time cash crops also, and bank also is giving the credit facilities. And every families, they used to have 2 to 3 animals, cows, goats and sheep, so that they are able to get benefit. In the same manner, in another region, in Maharashtra, about 200 meters of height, they are having only one crop, and whenever there will be a sufficient amount of rainfall, then only they can able to cultivate the second crop. Otherwise, there is a monocrop. When we compare to these two regions, Midnapore at one place and another village which is situated above the 200 meters of height, Midnapore is very developed and they are getting the proper resources and proper water facilities. That's why they are getting the fine seeds and from the university, and commercial seeds which are costly, they are not using. In the same manner, according to the nutrition, they are saying that proper calories are needed. What is the proper calories? Means they are showing that nearly per person, this is the last category of people. That means bottom section of the people. The bottom section of the people are able to have only 1624 calories of food, whereas next section of the people who are able to, this is the next section, this is last bottom 25% of population, this is second bottom category of the population, they people are able to consume 900 calories of food. And third quarter of the people, this is the third quarter of the people, they are able to have calories 2143. And next last category of the people, they are able to have 2521 calories. What is these calories? Here, what is the food that is available is not sufficient that must be reached to all sections of the people. Only production is not sufficient. We must see that food is reaching to each and every sections of the people. And according to the nutritionist suggest, in the rural area, at least nearly 2,400 calories of food must be taken. In urban area, nearly 2,100 calories of food must be taken. But here, only top 25 categories, last 25% of the people only able to take the more than the calories which was suggested by the nutrition. 25% bottom 25% of population are able to take only 1624 calories. If less amount of calories will be taken, then their strength also will be less, and then they cannot able to do hard work, and then they can able to earn less income. That means when low calories amount of food will be taken, means they are getting the less income. According to the nutritionist, if proper amount of calories of food will be taken, then only they can able to have the proper strength. This is because of poverty, and that is the main reason.